The purpose of this video is to show you how to make a home page for your Canvas course. A home page is where your students will go first when they click on a specific course. So we're going to go into my homeroom course. When my students go in, this is the first thing they see. This is your, I believe it's the activity feed. It's not very visually appealing, it's not very exciting, so I want to create something that's a little warmer and that tells them welcome, maybe gives them an instruction or a link of where to go. So I'm going to go to pages. I have some pages here, but I'm going to create a new page and I'm going to name it home page. So for pages, you have some options. You can choose to only write text, and I'll show you what I mean by that. So you can just choose to say, welcome to our class. You can, just like a Word document, you can edit the font, you can make it cute with these top icons. So I'm gonna bold it, I'm gonna make the font bigger, I'm gonna change the color, I'm gonna make it purple, I'm even gonna change the background color, I'm gonna make it blue, okay? And underneath, I'm gonna link my modules. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to hit modules, and I'm going to link my modules, and I'll show you what this does. So when you want to link any of your course content to your home page, you're going to hit links, and then you're going to pick the content that you want. So I want to link my modules. So I'm going to click on modules, and I'm going to create links to my modules. So when they highlight in yellow like that, that means they're links. So this is a purely text home page right now. We only use text features. So let's see what happens. We're gonna go down, we're gonna hit save. Well, actually, we'll give the students a direction. We'll say, click on a link to get started. And I'm actually gonna change the font because I'm a little bit of a perfectionist and I want it to all fit. So I'm gonna make it smaller. Okay. Click on a link below to get started. And I can even change the color if I wanted to. So for example, if I wanted to make this font red, I just highlight it and make it red, very similar to a Word document. Remember, these are links. See how they underline when I put my mouse over them? So now I'm gonna go down and hit save. Okay. Welcome to our class. Click on a link to get started. So now if I click on one of those links, look what happens. It takes me to my module where my work is. Pretty cool. So I'm going to go back to pages. I'm going to click on my home page that I created. Okay. So that's an example of a type of home page you could do with just text. But look, when I go home, that's not the home page I want, so stick with me. When you make a page in Pages, if you want it to be your home page, first you need to publish it by clicking the no smoking sign until it's green. Then click the three dots, see where it says use as front page? You're gonna hit use as front page. Now look what happens when we go home. Oh, I'm sorry, we have one more step. After you hit use as front page, I apologize. After you hit use as front page, you'll see it labeled as your front page. You need to go home, and where this says on the right side, choose home page, click on it and hit pages front page. You're gonna hit save. Now look what happens. Okay, this is my home page. The home link is bolded. So if I go to my dashboard, okay, and I click on homeroom, now the first thing my students see is this home page that we just created. So again, if you want to set a home page, you go to pages, you hit view all pages, And when your pages look like this, you're gonna highlight the page that you want. You're gonna make sure it's published. The circle needs to be green. You're gonna click these dots. And right now it says remove as front page, but it should say set as front page. You're gonna set it as your front page. You're gonna come home. You're gonna click choose home page and click on pages front page. All right, now that I've showed you how to set a home page, let's make a cute home page. So we're gonna go to pages, view all pages. I'm gonna click on that home page I made and I'm gonna hit edit. Okay, so instead of it saying welcome to our class, I want to add an image, a cute image that I picked out. So I'm gonna come over to images. I have two choices. So this button says search Flickr. I can search Flickr for a cute page or a cute picture. So I'm gonna write welcome and hit search. So these images come up from Flickr. So I can click on one and look what happens. It puts the image onto my home page. So then if I hit save, now this is my home page. But I don't really like that image. I already have an image I picked out and put on my desktop that I just want to upload. So I'm gonna hit edit. I'm gonna click on this image and I'm gonna hit delete. All right, now I'm going to upload an image from my desktop. So I'm gonna go to images, but instead of search, I'm gonna hit upload new image. I'm gonna hit choose file. And I'm gonna click on the image I picked and hit open. I'm gonna name the image. You must name it something. I'm gonna name it welcome. And I'm gonna hit upload. Now watch what happens. I have this beautiful image I picked out. I uploaded it from my desktop. So again, if you search in Flickr, those are images already on the internet. If you upload an image, those are images that you have on your desktop. So now I have welcome, click on a below link. Whoops, let's fix our English. Click on a link below to get started. And remember, we link these modules. I'll show you one more time how we link those modules. We went over to links and we clicked on modules and we selected a module. So if I wanted to add this module again, I would just click on it. And there it is, it showed up. If I want to take it off, I just highlight it and hit delete. You can also link quizzes, announcements, assignments, anything that you want. The last thing I will show you, this is a little more advanced, is if instead of it saying week of 3/30/20, if you want to have a different image or name for this link. It's a little more advanced. So if you're happy with what you already have, that's okay. So what you would want to do is search for an image. I'm going to look for a click here image. Let's see what comes up. I'm not really crazy about the options. Let's look for a start image. Okay. All right, they have a start image right here. So I'm gonna erase these because I wanna do something different. I'm gonna click on this start image. Okay, remember this is just an example. So if you're not crazy about the image, I'm gonna make it smaller. If you're not crazy about the image, it's okay. And I'm just gonna write click image or click to get started. And I'm gonna make the font smaller. And I'm gonna make the font black. Again, we are in pages, we are just editing a page. Okay, now I want this image to take me to my modules. You can actually do that. So here's what we do. I'm gonna go to links. I'm gonna open modules. I'm gonna click on start. Give me 1 second. I wanna make sure I show you guys the right way to do this. Okay. And after I click on my image, I'm gonna click on the module that I want that image to take me to. So I'm gonna click on this. See how it just highlighted? Watch what happens. We're gonna go down and save. So now when my students come onto my homepage, it says welcome, and it says click to get started. This button, this image is a link now. Watch what happens when I click on it. Start. It took me to the modules. So now let's go to dashboard and start from the beginning. I'm gonna click on my homeroom page. This is the first thing my students see. There's my welcome image. They cannot click on this because I did not make that image a link, but I did make this image a link. So if my students click on start, it takes them here. Again, there are so many ways that you can edit the pages and you can make it super cute. You can make a really unique home page. I do recommend you just get the basics of Canvas down first. This video is once you have kind of set up your course the way you want it. But there are so many things you can do, so many files you can add, images, links to these. You can add links to Microsoft Teams. There's a lot you can do with your homepage. So just make it fun, make it something that you're comfortable with and that you feel like will be user-friendly to your students. I know this video was a little more advanced, so if you need anything or have any questions, just leave me a comment.